450D03, and this is basically the helicopter that supersedes the 450D01. And we'll just go over some of the differences and similarities between both helicopters. All right, first off the bat, it's a beautiful canopy that Walkera has made. And if you notice, the lettering says V450D03, but we don't think the camera captures it. But if you look at the yellow in the background, it actually says V450D03 also in the back, and it's on both sides of the canopy. So we're going to take off the canopy right now and see what's inside a helicopter. But before we just finish off doing this, the canopies are actually that Walkera is making now are now seamless. So before there used to be a seam here, and on a minor crash it would crack. Well, now there's no more seams, so these canopies are made a lot better and they don't crack, and they're putting more detail in the canopies, which is a really nice feature that Walkera is doing. Okay folks, let's see what the inside of the helicopter has. Lift it up here. Basically, we'll go off some of the differences, and basically what Walkera has done is they changed their entire airframe. It used to be on the V450D01, it used to be an all carbon fiber frame. This is actually a plastic carbon fiber resin frame. Basically, particles of carbon fiber are mixed into the plastic. It makes the plastic a lot more stronger and more rigid. And at the same time, because it's using plastic, it's very light. The airframe is lighter than the carbon fiber. So that's a nice feature that Walkera has done. They also, the rotor head is actually a composite of the metal and plastic carbon fiber blade grips. The blade grips are nice and thick, all right, and they do give a little bit sway when flying using plastic. So sometimes when you land a helicopter or fly a helicopter, it might wobble a little bit or vibrate a little bit because of the plastic blade grips. Having said that, it's not a bad thing. They also changed the swash plate. The swash plate is now all metal. It used to be a composite, so it's a lot better. Also, they changed the brushless motor system. The brushless motor is now, it's still an outrunner, but it's a lighter brushless motor in terms of less metal. It has fins actually on the motor, so as it spins, it actually sucks in the wind, the air a lot better to cool down the motor. It's running at 3,500 RPM, which is a plenty of power per kV. Some of the similarities, it's using the same plastic gear system that's also found on the 450D01. So if you have the spare parts for it, it's a direct replacement. Also, Walkera is using the same speed controller. This is a 40 amp speed controller, which is the same that's found on the V450D01. Also, on this helicopter, we're using an 11.12 2200 mAh LiPo battery. The LiPo battery that comes standard with this helicopter is actually an 11.1 2650 mAh battery. So you actually have more flight time with the helicopter. We're just using the 2200 today because it's a little bit lighter, and it's the same one that's used on the V450D01. Also notice here is using the same digital tail servo. This is the oversized high-speed digital tail servo. So you have excellent control on your tail rudder, okay? So again, if we're already buying the helicopter, so if I look at the tail rudder, spins, turns really nice. Lots of control, okay? And also, the more important thing that we want to note is it's using, Walkera is using the heart of the engine for this helicopter is the Walkera Dimension 2703H-D. It's a six-channel, six-axis integrated receiver. So as opposed to the previous version, it's just a six-axis versus a three-axis. So this can fly really stable, folks. Also, Walkera changed the carbon fiber blades. They added a little bit more white to the edges. So we like that because as the helicopter spools up as you're flying, it's a lot easier to see the edges of your helicopter rotor blade, so you don't really have to accidentally hit something because you can see the edges as opposed to before when it's all black. Okay folks, we already binded the helicopter to the Walkera Devo 7 transmitter. Any Devo 7 transmitter or higher will work. So Devo 7, a Devo 8, 8S, Devo 10, a Devo 12, and 12S will work using this particular receiver and setup for the Walkera V450D03. All right, we're gonna get a test flight to see how stable this helicopter is. It is a little bit windy today, but that's great because it'll demonstrate how stable the six-axis gyro integrated receiver is on this particular helicopter. Okay folks, here we go. Right off the bat, you can see how stable the helicopter is using the six-axis gyro system. And let's see, if we yaw to our left and yaw to our right on the rudder, you see the solid tail control, folks. All right, and of course, if we bang to our left or we bang to our right, the helicopter always wants to stay in a hovering position. So anyone flying this helicopter, it's going to be a joy for any beginner or even a professional to fly because it's really stable. It's using the new lighter 3,500 RPM motor. So we'll see how fast this can throttle up. Here we go, up. And of course, it's using the same main gear system, which is auto rotation. So the helicopter actually drifts down when you cut the power, which is really nice. And let's see, it's a little windy today, but it should be really stable to fly this helicopter. Here we go across the yard here. You can really zoom fast across. And because this is a six-axis, six-gyro helicopter, you can do aerobatic flying. Today we'll just do normal flight mode. Helicopter spins well. Excellent tail recovery. And anyone who's flown the 450D01 using the three-axis, you'll definitely like this helicopter because of the stability with the six-axis. And also on our website, we actually have a mod where it's a very simple mod. Basically, all you need is the new 2703D-H receiver, and you can replace your 450D01 to become a six-axis integrated receiver. So you'll be just as stable as the 450D03. All right, let's see. Go around a little bit. See how stable it is. Great for making, we'll circle around. Lots of pickup and power. Let's see if we get a close-up shot. We'll go it out again. Boy, folks, this is a joy to fly. Are we going to land it? Woo. All right, there you have it, folks. The new Walkira V450D03. Helicopter. It's the latest from Walkira and an updated version of the V450D01. It's made of plastic composite carbon fiber parts as well as molded with metal parts. The more important thing is using the new six-axis gyro, which makes this helicopter fly really super stable. And because Walkira is using the plastic carbon fiber parts, it actually makes this helicopter cost less than the older 450D01. So get yours today. Okay, folks, that's a wrap.